guys, welcome back. Today we're going to be swatching through my next collection launching from Moonshine Mani, which is coming out this Friday, May 8th. This collection is a quad inspired by my favorite mystery writer, Agatha Christie, probably one of my favorite authors of all time. And I picked four of my most favorite of her mystery novels, and we have a polish for each of those written works. And then we have one bonus polish this month that you can get for free in the first 48 hours after launch at 9 a.m. Pacific Standard Time on May 8th. So for those next 48 hours, you can get the last polish we're gonna look at for free if you're purchasing the whole quad. So this is called the Queen of Crime Collection. Everything has a variation of flaky. We have gold flakies, we have multichrome flakies, we have some delicate micro holographic flakies, some platinum flakies, we have chameleon flakies. There's kind of a mix and match among all the formulas. They're not any of them the same, and there is some crossing between the polishes for components that I've used, but we have a little bit of a different formula in each of the five polishes, including the add-on. So we're also going to be looking at my next upcoming Project Dupe It polish for May. We're going to go ahead and take a look at that first. So if you're new to Project Dupe It, each month I create a polish that's inspired by a popular kind of lemming mainstream polish from years past. This month I'm doing a polish inspired by China Glaze Wish on a Starfish. And this is a textured polish. It's like a soft powdery pink with a lot of gold fleck in it, and it's texture. So if you're new to textured polish, it's meant to look bumpy on the nail. It's meant to have a texture. Lots of times you'll take a smoothing glossy top coat and use it to smooth out any glitters or flakies or anything. With this kind of formulation, you purposefully aren't doing that. You're letting it dry completely on its own and not adding top coat. However, with this formula, you can certainly add top coat. It brings out even more of the glow and the fleck in this polish. And so you can kind of wear it both ways. I have swatchers that have swatched it both ways for you, and I will show you it swatched both ways as well. So my interpretation of this polish is called If Wishes Were Starfishes. And like I said, it's a powdery, light pink. It's definitely like a warm toned pink, and it has all of this delicious gold fleck that's bringing it more warm. And the component that's making this a texture polish is a glitter. I have a variety of sizes that I chose for this polish, and it's an iridescent glitter. So not only is it forming the texture that's making up the finish of this polish, but it's giving you all of this gorgeous iridescent flip on the nail. This polish is going to be permanent on my website. All Project Dupe It polishes are, and they have a separate section on the website. If you go look at the left-hand side or at the main menu of the website, you can see all of our past Project Dupe It's if you are new to the collection and you want to try some favorite lemmings from nail polish collectors. Okay, so the Queen of Crime collection, like I said, it's a quad. You can get all four of these polishes if you want to buy it as a set for $42. That gives you about a 10% savings. And if you're purchasing it in those first 48 hours after launch, you're getting that fifth one for free, so you're getting even more savings that way. You can totally buy the fifth polish I'm going to share with you, the bonus add-on, separately if that's like the only one that you were interested in. You can buy any of these polishes separately. I just bundle them for you to give you that savings. So we're going to start with a Caribbean Mystery, and so this is one of the two purpley mauve shades. This is the more bright violet mauve out of the two, and like I said, they all have flakies in some variation. They have like a mix and match of different flakies that I thought would complement the polish. So I describe a Caribbean Mystery as a rich violet mauve crelly accented with pink to purple to blue iridescent and multichrome flakies and soft gold flakies. So both the multichrome flaky, which is the kind that is creating the kind of dark freckle on the nail, that's a multichrome flaky. It's still shifting between color, but it has a darker appearance because it's multichrome pigment. And then the iridescent flaky is the one that the light passes through, and that one is also purple, blue, pink. And then I added an accent of beautiful soft gold flakies. They felt very fitting for this collection. The next polish is And Then There Were None. I describe And Then There Were None as a medium rose tan crelly packed with red to gold to green iridescent flakies and delicate micro hollow flakies. So you get quite a lot of flakies on the nail with this polish built up in two coats. That's what I'm swatching it for you today. And I just really love this darker rose tan shade. It's such a beautiful shade to wear. And all of these colors are really complementary to a lot of skin tones. So we did two easy coats of this beautiful bouncy Crelly. Next up, we're gonna look at the other rosy tan shade, and this one is Death on the Nile. And this is the one that I reread most recently. This is a Hercule Poirot book. And so you have her two most famous detectives, Miss Marple, and then you have Hercule Poirot, and they're two very different kind of characters who solve mysteries throughout a number of her books. And so Death on the Nile I describe as a light rose tan Crelly filled with pink, green, gold, iridescent flakies, and soft gold flakies. So this one is just giving you kind of a rainbow of flaky in the bottle, and you're getting those soft gold flakies again as well, giving a nice like soothing complement to the bright rainbow flakies. And I'm just showing you two coats here. I'm gonna finish everything off with the Moonshine Mani Let's Go Quick Dry top coat today as well, because we want to smooth down all those flakies and give a nice long-lasting finish to the nail. The next polish we're going to look at is They Came to Baghdad, and this is the final polish in the base quad. So this polish is the darker of the two violet mauves, and I describe it as a deep violet mauve Crelly filled with platinum flakies, delicate micro hollow flakies, and navy to violet shifting multi-chrome flakies. And this one is probably not one of the necessarily like fan favorites. I personally really enjoy it, and I've reread it a number of times, but I haven't seen it on a lot of like top 10 lists. But I wanted to include this one for this collection because it includes some romance in the book. This one is definitely very opaque at two coats. You aren't gonna need more than that, and there's a lot of flakies packed on the nail there in the two coats. So that's what I'm showing to you with top coat, giving you macro shots of everything. And now I'm gonna swatch the bonus add-on. So again, this is the polish you get for free if you're purchasing all four of those polishes we just looked at. I will add this to your package for free. You don't need to add it to your order or anything. When you add the full collection, it just auto-generates into your order. So don't worry about if you have to click on anything extra. But that expires on Sunday, May 10th at 9 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. So this polish is probably my favorite Agatha Christie book. It doesn't have a super, super high reread factor, because once you experience the amazing twists of this book, you already kind of know what's gonna happen. I have reread it a number of times just so that I can like remember what it was like when I read this book, and I was just like, I thought I had it all figured out, and I did not. It's just such a huge, fun twist, so surprising. And it really is actually kind of famous for what it did for mystery writing. And so I definitely recommend this one if you haven't tried The Murder of Roger Ackroyd yet. Please read it. It's really, really great. So this is my navy blue, and this is definitely another soft Crelly formula. I describe The Murder of Roger Ackroyd as a dusty navy blue flecked with fuchsia, blue, gold, multi-chrome flakies, and purple to blue iridescent flakies. That is the full Queen of Crime collection for May 2020. We'll have to see how long I can go before I need to add more polishes to this collection. But you guys, I'm such a fan, and if I haven't imparted anything to you in this video, besides the fact that you should definitely read Agatha Christie, I hope that you got that much from it. I really appreciate you stopping by for this video and listening to me gush about my love for Agatha Christie and my love for polish making. And I hope you can feel that through my polish. It's just such a joy to share my creative process with you in these videos too. So those of you who stuck around here to the end, you are awesome and epic, and thank you. And if this is still not enough for you, two more videos will pop up on the screen if you'd like to hang out some more. I'd love to spend a little bit more time with you. I hope you're having a great day. Take care of yourself. I will see you back for another video very soon. Until then, bye.